Whether you're a wizard or muggle, there's something for everyone. Potterheads often compare any story to the tale of the boy who lived. So we've gathered 10 movies like the Harry Potter franchise. Each one would deliver exactly the right dose of fantasy, magic, and love protagonists, like the boy who lived. So enough talking. Here are the top 10 movies you should watch if you liked Harry Potter. Number 10, The Golden Compass, 2007. Based on the 1995 book, Northern Lights, this is the first one out of three written by Philip Pullman. If you are a fan of fantasy, adventure films, you would love this, guaranteed. The movie is written and directed by Chris Weitz and has some pretty good actors in it, such as Nicole Kidman, Daniel Craig, Ian McKellen, Eva Green. The film was released in cinemas in late 2007. It tells the story of Lyra Belacqua, a young girl who lives in a parallel world where human souls take form as animal companions called daemons. Isn't that great? I would definitely live in this world. How about you? As the story progresses, Lyra discovers that her best friend is disappeared, along with another children of her world. So she starts her journey to save them. HBO rumored that they will make a series based on the novel trilogy. Number 9. Bridge to Terabithia, 2007. You know when a movie is made by Walt Disney Pictures, you could not hate it. Even if you wanted, Bridge to Terabithia is a movie based on the 1977 novel of the same name, written by Katherine Patterson. The story centers on a preteen's life, Jesse Aarons, and turns upside down when he befriends the new girl in school, Leslie Burke. They together create an imaginary world full of magical creatures called Terabithia, in which they rule as king and queen. Man, I wish I had powers like that. As the story progresses, tragedy strikes, and the mystical land becomes a source of comfort and hope. The movie was filmed for several months and was released early in 2007, directed by Gaber Supo. In the movie, starred Josh Hutcherson, Anna Sophia Robb as main characters. If you haven't seen this movie, you better see it. You won't regret it. Number 8. Pan's Labyrinth. If foreign language doesn't stop you to watch some great movies, then you should check out this gem of a movie. Pan's Labyrinth, or El Laberinto del Fauno, is a dark fantasy film written and directed by Guillermo del Toro. The movie was released mid-2006, and its main actors were Ivana Baquero, Maribel Verdo, Sergi Lopez, and Doug Jones. The story sets in the summer of 1944 in Spain, 5 years after the Spanish Civil War. The plot centers around a young girl named Ophelia, who is fascinated by fairy tales, and is sent along with her pregnant mother to live with her new stepfather, who is a ruthless captain of the Spanish army. Then, she meets a mythical creature called Fawn, who tells her she is a princess. However, she must prove her royalty by taking 3 deadly tasks, which she must survive. The movie won 3 Academy Awards and many other awards in 2007. Well, that speaks of itself. I won't hesitate to watch this movie. You should do that too. And number 7, Matilda, 1996. On our number 7 spot is an older movie from the 90s, but that doesn't make it less watchable. Based on another Roald Dahl story, Matilda tells a story of a genius young girl under the watchful eye of a cruel principal and neglectful parents. In the movie, Matilda is despised and misunderstood by her family because she is very different from their ways of life. She finally starts going to school. However, she is constantly bullied by her ruthless, oppressive, and tyrannical principal. After some time, Matilda begins to realize that she has some kind of telekinetic powers. Does that remind you of someone? After practicing it for a few days, Matilda finally turns the tables to stand up to her parents and her principal. The movie received good critical responses and reviews. It was released on August 2nd, 1996, and was produced and directed by Danny DeVito, who also served as the narrator. Tell us in the comments section below what do you think about this movie. And of course, don't forget to like and subscribe. Number 6. Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, 2005. As our number six, we have another Roald Dahl novel story, which is directed by the famous Tim Burton and written by John August. Charlie and the Chocolate Factory is definitely a much-watched fantasy movie, released in mid-2005. The film stars Johnny Depp, Freddie Highmore as main stars, alongside David Kelly, Christopher Lee, Missy Pyle, and others. The plot begins as Willy Wonka, Johnny Depp, decides to let five children into his chocolate factory and releases five golden tickets in five separate chocolate bars. The tickets start to be found, with the fifth going to an impoverished young boy named Charlie. The five children were chosen to experience a rare, fantastical visit to the chocolate factory, with one purpose only, that Willy Wonka needs a successor in his factory, as he thinks he got old. As the movie progresses, not everything goes to plan within the factory. We won't spoil anything else. You gotta see the movie. You won't regret. Number 5. A Series of Unfortunate Events, 2004. Orphaned, just like Harry Potter, the three wealthy Baudelaire siblings lose their parents in a massive fire, which burns their house down in mysterious circumstances. They are left in the custody of a distant relative, Count Olaf. Although the Count took the kids in, but the one thing he does want is the children's inheritance from their parents. The Count makes the kids do his chores and makes them cook dinner for him. As the story progresses, he tries to kill them, but fails. The children then are taken to a safer guardian. However, the Count doesn't give up. The movie was directed by Brad Siberling and released in 2004. It's a film adaptation of A Series of Unfortunate Events by Lemony Snicket, covering the first three novels. In the movie, starred Jim Carrey as the Count, alongside Liam Aiken, Emily Browning, Timothy Spall, Meryl Streep, and Jude Law. In 2014, Netflix announced its plans of creating a television series to adapt the entire novel series. Number 4. Fantastic Beast Films, 2016. Well, on our fourth spot, we have entered the secret community of witches and wizards, but not the same timeline as Harry Potter. These films take place 70 years before Harry first appeared in Hogwarts. The story is written straight from the mind of Rowling herself and centered on Newt Scamander, a quirky magizoologist. In the first film, Scamander loses his precious leather suitcase, which shelters a wide array of diverse and magical creatures that exist among us. Several creatures will manage to escape and wreak havoc on Fifth Avenue. The second installment is concentrated on Grindelwald's plans of raising pure-blood wizards to rule over non-magical beings. So young Albus Dumbledore asks his former student, Scamander, for help, who agrees. However, he's unaware of the dangers that lie ahead. The first film was released in 2016, with the second following with its release in 2018. The third film is set to premiere in 2021. I wouldn't think twice to check out these movies if you're into magic. Number 3. The Chronicles of Narnia Trilogy, 2005-2010. If you're a Potterhead, you will love the mysteries and magic of Narnia, guaranteed. Adapted from the 1950s C.S. Lewis fantasy novels, The Chronicles of Narnia follows the four British Pevensey siblings as they discover an unassuming wardrobe that leads them to the magical world of Narnia. After they discover the wardrobe, the four children go in together for the last time. They battle wolves, meet talking animals, encounter an evil white witch, and meet a magnificent lion named Asian. In the second installment, the siblings return to Narnia, where they are enlisted to once again help ward off an evil king and restore the rightful heir, Prince Caspian. In the third film, Lucy and Edmund return to Narnia for a trip across the sea aboard the royal ship, the Dawn Treader. Along the way, they encounter dragons, dwarves, and a band of lost warriors. Number 2. Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children, 2016. Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children is a 2016 fantasy film directed by Tim Burton. Based on the 2011 novel of the same name by Ransom Riggs, the story follows a teen named Jacob who discovers a magical school called Miss Peregrine's School for Peculiar Children, where he meets an array of children with special powers and abilities. But the danger deepens after he gets to know the residents and learns about their special powers and their powerful enemies. And soon, he becomes embroiled in dangerous mystery that crosses various worlds and times. So Jacob discovers that only his own special peculiarity can save his new friends. The movie is billed as Tim Burton's X-Men, and we like that comparison a lot. Have you thought of seeing this film? If not, we recommend it to you. We promise you that you won't waste your time. Number 1. The Lord of the Rings Trilogy, 2001-2003. Maybe you have guessed that Lord of the Rings is our top pick for today's video, and we are almost 100% sure that you have seen it. So perhaps it is time for watching this legendary trilogy once again. Adapted from the legendary J.R.R. Tolkien fantasy novel, fans frequently compare this series to Harry Potter. What do you think? Which series is superior? Tell us in the comments section below. The Lord of the Rings is based in the fictional world of Middle-earth, in which a hobbit named Frodo Baggins, along with 8 other companions, fight to destroy the sinister One Ring and its creator, the Dark Lord Sauron. The story had 3 installments: The Fellowship of the Ring, The Two Towers, and The Return of the King. The adaptation was directed by Peter Jackson, and all 3 parts of the trilogy won multiple Academy Awards, with the final part winning a total of 11 Oscars. Would you agree with our list? If we missed some magical movies, tell us in the comments section below. If you want more content like this, make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the bell button to get notifications as soon as our new video pops up. Thank you for watching.